Thank you. Test. 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 Testing. Testing.
Welcome this afternoon. I'm Paige Wallison, reporter from the Des Moines Register. We're live tonight in Des Moines, Iowa for the first of a series of the 2012 presidential debates. We are here during the prestigious and fun-filled Iowa State Fair. But before we begin tonight, please rise and salute the flag with the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ms. Schrader, you may begin.
This debate is sponsored by the Iowa 4-H Foundation. Here's the format for our debate tonight. Both candidates will be asked several questions on 4-H issues that affect us within our communities and states. Answers are limited to 1 minute each. Mr. President, you may go first with a 1 minute introduction.
As President of the United States of America, I would like to say thank you to the Iowa State Fair Board for hosting such a prestigious debate, especially during such a busy time.
This debate, thank you, Mr. President.
I wasn't finished, let me finish. Aww. It has been a pleasure serving this country the past 4 years, and I'm optimistic about the upcoming election. And all 4 years across this great land will be pleased to hear what decisions I have that they're struggling with problems.
Okay, now I will start. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Romney, you have a 1 minute introduction.
Thank you, Ms. Schrader, and I too want to thank you, Iowa State Fair Board for hosting such a fine event. America, we launched this campaign over a year ago last June, and it has been an extraordinary journey. Americans have always been eternal optimists, and Barack Obama has had the last 4 years to show you the best that he can do. Now I'm asking you to allow me the privilege and opportunity to show America the best that I can do as your next president. I have several plans for those 4-H'ers who are tired of suffering from the state economy.
Thank you, Mr. Romney. Our first question will begin with you, Mr. President. With the economy still struggling, much of federal funding to the 4-H Foundation is being cut. What do 4-H foundations like the 4-H Foundation stay afloat?
Well, with over 4 million jobs created in the last 2 years, are we satisfied?
No!
Of course not. I have a plan after my re-election on November 6th to write a bill that will add a 1% 4-H sales tax on all purchases of anything that is bought by the wealthy, such as boats, Lamborghinis, or, say, combine. This money will go to the 4-H Foundation.
Governor Romney, you have a 1 minute response.
The 4-H Foundation has empowered youth for many years, providing financial resources to develop and deliver quality 4-H. As a private business owner myself, I know the struggles that organizations face. I too have a plan for helping out the 4-H Foundation. And unlike you, Mr. President, another tax is not what Americans want. My plan is to have my wife hold a 4-H fundraiser in each state and to raffle off a golfing with the president outing.
Thank you, Governor Romney. Our next question tonight has to do with PETA, which has been around for many of years. What would you say to this organization who says about state and county fairs? And I am quoting from their website, animals suffer tremendously when they are crated from town to town and forced to perform. They live in almost constant state of discomfort, frustration, depression, and anxiety. Governor Romney, you first.
That is absolutely so far from the truth about how 4-H'ers and FFA kids care for their animals at these fairs. I've been to these fairs, and I've been to these fairs, and the animals are treated better than most pets that are kept in houses. Listen, PETA has not been my fan for over the years. They didn't like it when I had a rodeo at the Olympics, and more recently, they didn't like the fact that I traveled with our dog, Seamus, on the top of our car during a vacation. And Seamus loved being in the fresh air, didn't you, Seamus? It's just my dog.
Mr. President, your response?
Well, PETA hasn't exactly relished the fact that I saw them apply during an interview with CNBC. I'm optimistic about the capacity that these four agents will meet their obligations to one another and their animals. Got it.
Thank you, gentlemen. Our last question tonight, what's the one thing you want to do for local 4-H clubs? Mr. President, you first.
Look this country forward. I would like to see 4-H care put in place. It would be a required sign-up by all 4-H. Then they will take care of you if any financial assistance who need to participate in any 4-H activities such as camps, workshops, or fair exhibits.
Governor Romney, your response?
When generations of immigrants looked up and saw the Statue of Liberty for the first time, one thing they knew without a doubt was that they were coming to America, where opportunities would be beyond their imaginations. Generations have believed that by joining 4-H, their children would have a better life. I believe in that 4-H. I believe that you believe in that 4-H. We are united in one great passion. We stand out for our club, our community, our country, and our world. I'm Mitt Romney, and I approve this message.
Thank you, gentlemen. We will now turn to our distinguished guest in the audience for questions. Mr. Trump, do you have a question?
Thank you, Mr. Trump.
Well, I'm not officially running for president. However, I'm once again considering jumping into the race if you two don't get your acts together. My ratings for The Apprentice are down, and I need to attract more viewers. Would you both be willing to appear on a special season of Presidential Apprentice? We could have 20 politicians competing for the presidency, and I would get to choose who gets hired and who gets fired. What do you say, guys?
No.
I agree.
Thank you, Mr. Trump. We now have a question from America's snowboarding gold medalist, Sean White.
Hey dudes, my question's for Mitt Romney. You did such an awesome job running the Winter Olympics in Salt Lake City. I was just wondering if you could like dump this whole presidential thing and go to the Winter Olympics in Russia. We could be like spies for the United States and maybe do some curling.
Thank you for your kind words, Mr. White, but I plan on negotiating some peace talks with the Russians. Besides, we don't have spies in other countries.
Thank you, Mr. Romney. Our last guest has a question for you, Mr. President. Go ahead, Mr. Ron Paul Delegate.
Yes, well, as you know, the Ron Paul Revolution has not just been about getting Ron Paul elected president. It is about liberty and changing the GOP party. This has been done from the grassroots level and up. What advice, Mr. President, would you give these 4-H members in the audience here today that would encourage them to be a part of the grassroots organization?
Grassroots are the essence of politics. It could be helping Piano Harbor or handing out flyers at the fair. I started out as community organizer, then became senator and then president. If you have situations one will improve within 4-H, you could easily stand up and make a change for the better.
We've had a good debate, but we are nearing the end. We will now have our closing statements. Governor Romney will be first.
I believe this is a critical election. I believe that the founders took very careful thought in the preparation of the Declaration of Independence that said that the Creator has endowed us with certain unalienable rights, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. I believe that kids across America would be fulfilling this pursuit of happiness if they would simply join 4-H and have their parents vote for me.
Mr. President, your closing statement?
We're still finding our way back from the worst economic crisis since the Great Depression. We cannot afford to give up in these last 2 months. When we come together, we can do anything, especially 4-H'ers. You guys know how to work together doing community service, leadership projects, and citizenship activities. We must keep moving forward.
Thank you, Mr. President and Governor Romney. It's been an uplifting and informative debate. We hope you know more about your candidates and have learned more about 4-H and how important it is to America. Thank you for joining us tonight. We will see you again in August for our next debate. God bless America and good night.
I'm Maggie Steinkamp. I'm an intermediate.
I'm Paige Wallison. I'm a junior.
I'm Garrett Hugeback, and I'm a junior.
I'm Corey Odman, and I'm a junior.
I'm Marison Schlepp, and I'm a junior.
I'm Kylie Schrader. I'm a junior.
I'm Bailey Wallison, and I'm a junior.
I'm Derek Ashinger, and I'm a junior.
I'm Kevin Steinkamp, and I'm a junior.
I'm Michael Feinsman, and I'm an intermediate.
beyond the city lights, rise a cowboy's paradise, honeysuckle on the vine, growing up on Southern time. We love to dance and we love to flirt, ain't afraid of a little dirt. We lay for Sunday church, mama raised us not to curse. Choose a little shorter, cause the sun's a little sipping lemonade, and we're playing in the water. Oh, 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 reason why the balls pick Georgia. The grass is green, we got home grown in our jeans. We love country, everything. We'll call and drive you crazy when we wink and call you baby. You don't stand a chance once you've seen us Southern lady. Oh, 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 ain't nothing sweeter than Georgia peaches. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight we are going to do something special, and we're going to do a little bit of Taylor County dance off. And we've got our okay team on the far side. And then we've got the awesome team right here behind me, because we're totally going to dominate. So when we're doing this dance off, we're going to have you guys kind of vote on who's doing like the best. So whatever team gets the most applause is a team that wins. And we've got four songs, you know, trying to keep it going here. So we'll just start with the first song. End of our first dance. So we've got, you guys can vote, you know, we've got that team. And then we've got this team. Okay, I think that says it. Our team won. Yeah. Okay, so we'll move on to the next dance. Number two, who puts it up for that team? And our team? Well, I guess that didn't go as planned. Okay, number three. didn't know that dance ended up on the floor, but that team. Our team. I say it's 2-2. And that kind of tends to be a problem because we have no actual winner. So we have, like, we voted on team captains, and we kind of have these sibling pair, you know. And we've got our captains out that are going to finish out the dance. So let's give it up for our captains so they can finish our dance. Okay, let's try that again because I really didn't quite get that one. Devin! Audrey? I have to admit, I kind of think Devin got that one. Thanks for watching!
What is it? Let's see the proof. Okay, that was pretty cool, but I'm gonna have to see him some more.
Well, I got something. This tiny cup doesn't feed my animals. It takes like an hour to feed them. Wow, this will only take me 30.6 seconds now.
I really need help. This fish hook really hurts my pigs in the show ring. I'm fishing for something better. Wow, my pigs will like this a lot more, but a lot better.
It looks like this 4-H machine really does do magic. It solved all of our problems.
I wish this egg would hatch. It was supposed to hatch a year ago. This is taking way too long. I'm going to put it in the machine and see what happens. Seems to be working for everyone else. Oh my gosh, this is awesome. I'm going to bring my 2-year-old eggs and see what happens next.
What is this?
Oh, I get it. 4-H brightens our world.
Special thank you to Catherine Jardin, a former member of the group Nishina Knights, for writing this song for us.
Thank you, Josh, for sharing your amazing piano talents with us. Our next act is Brittany Furch from Adair County. She will be singing God's Will.
Was dressed as a bag of leaves. It hit the braces on his legs at first. His smile was as bright as the August sun when he looked at me. As he struggled down the driveway, it almost made me hurt. Will don't walk too good. Will don't talk too good. He won't do the things that the other kids do in our neighborhood. I've been searching, wondering, thinking, lost and looking all my life. I've been wounded, jaded, loved and hated. I've wrestled wrong and right. It was a boy without a father and his mother's miracle. I've been reading, writing, praying, fighting. I guess I would be still. Yeah, that was until I knew God's will. Will's mom had to work two jobs. We'd watch him when she had to work late. We'd all laugh like I hadn't laughed since I don't know when. Hey Jude was his favorite song. At dinner he'd ask to pray. And then he'd pray for everybody in the world but him. I've been searching, wondering, thinking, lost and looking all my life. I've been wounded, jaded, loved and hated. I've wrestled wrong and right. It was a boy without a father and his mother's miracle. And writing, praying, fighting, I guess I would be still. Yeah, that was until I knew God's will. Before they moved to California, his mother said they didn't think he'd live. And she said each day that I have him, well, it's just another gift. And I never got to tell her that the boy showed me the truth. In crayon red on notebook paper, it written me in God, love you. I've been searching, praying, wounded, jaded. I guess I would be still. Yeah, that was until I met God's will on a Halloween night. He was dressed as a bag of leaves.